up, guys? Vince Carter here. Let's take a trip down memory lane of some of the greatest dunks of my career. Enjoy. So here's number 10.
Christie sees a lane, drops it off the corner.
I was thinking, first of all, Doug Christie was going to try to dunk the ball himself, so I tend to slow down, and all of a sudden I see him take a peek back and flip the ball back. I ended up doing like a reverse backwards dunk. So number 9, playing with the Nets against the Magic, one of my homecomings. J. Kidd, he knew I was going back door and he wasn't looking. And then he stops and just throws it up there. I jumped in the air and just like, wherever the ball goes, I'll figure it out.
Oh, my. Carter with a little icing on the cake in Orlando.
All right, number 8 in Toronto against the Milwaukee Bucks. So we got a steal. Muggsy gives me the ball, throws the ball ahead. This is one of the few times I actually said I'm going to do a windmill. And I actually did a windmill. I go right at the rim. Number 7. This is the All-Star game in Denver. I threw it off the backboard and you can see everybody stop like, wait, what? Type thing, and the rest was history off the backboard. And the reason I threw it off the backboard is because now if I throw it up really high, I can jump really high, which made for a great finish. Classic number 6, my rookie year versus Atlanta, my good friend Dikembe Mutombo, trying to make my mark. I get the opportunity to swing through baseline, took the one dribble, and I saw him there, and I said, my mentality was jump to the top of the square, and I knew he could. He had long arms, but his arms aren't that long.
Carter elevates and throws it down.
This elevation city just keeps going and going.
They're still talking about it over on the Toronto bench. My goodness.
Number 5, I was in Toronto playing against the Clippers at home. As I jumped from a far distance, Olu Candy jumped, and he already landed, so I kind of ducked my head, and it ended up being a windmill dunk. And it's funny, because once I made the dunk, I looked back like, did I actually make it? Because I'd never tried it before, and it was just all instinct that took over. And it was like out-of-body experience a little bit.
Here comes McGrady on the break. Down court, Vince Carter, he flies in, and
Number 4, Toronto versus the Cleveland Cavaliers. I get a steal on the break off of one dribble. I picked the ball up. I ended up pulling off probably one of the better 360 dunks, and it was the first one of my career. And it's a staple of doing that dunk later on, but none of them was like the first one.
Ahead of the pack, showtime! Oh, no! A 360 with one hand!
Number 3, playing for Toronto in LA versus the Clippers. We get a steal, Charles Oakley gets the ball, throws it ahead to D. Brown. D. Brown catches the ball and just turns and throws the ball in the air. And we didn't practice this, it was just like improv right there on the spot. People always ask, what were you thinking? I don't know. I had a clear mind. It was just balls behind me, catch the ball, put the ball in the rim, and something magical happened. All right, moving to number 2. Playing for Toronto at Indiana, and I had Chris Mullin on. I could see I can get by him, and I see Rick Smith, but he's trying to jump him away from him. Like, he didn't want to be on a poster, but he wanted to block my shot or dunk. So once I reversed it, I see the rim. I was like, well, it's here, I'm here, might as well dunk it. Oh, I remember it like it was yesterday. Oh, good old number 1. I played with Jersey against the Miami Heat at Miami. I take the ball, wrap around my back. I was concentrating more than any dunk that I've ever made in my life because I was like, this is gonna go down in history. Alonzo Mourning, one of the greatest shot blockers of all time. I'm floating, everything just slowed down in slow motion. I'm looking at the rim and I just like, boom, dunk. There it was. It was a great moment. Sorry, Zo.
Alonzo Mourning has said in the past, you can't be afraid of people dunking on you if you're a shot blocker. They're going to get you once in a while.
Talk about large. How about that slam dunk from Vince Carter? What body control and what power by Carter.
There you have it, my top 10.